I've seen a lot of beautiful things out there. There's just sometimes you're out there and you have like a little moment, and that's part of why we all go out and do what we do.
Good morning, we've talked the whole night through.
Good morning
to you.
Good morning, it's great to stay up late. Good morning to you.
band began to play. The stars were shining bright.
Now the milkman's on his way. It's too late to say goodnight.
So good morning, good morning. Sunbeams will soon smile through. Good morning, good morning to you and you and you and you.
Good morning, good morning. We've gabbed the whole night through. Good morning, good morning to you.
Nothing could be grander than to be in Louisiana.
In the morning, in the morning, it's great to stay up late. Good morning, good morning to you.
Might be just as zippy if we was in Mississippi.
When we left the movie show, the future wasn't bright. But came the dawn, the show goes on, and I don't want to say goodnight.
Don't say good morning.
Good morning.
Rainbows are shining through.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Bonjour.
Bonsoir.
Buenos dias.
Muchas gracias.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Good morning.
Guten Morgen.
Good morning to you.
Yeah, you're tripping me out, Bob.
Did you want to ride?
Oh, yeah.
gone to the point where there's a bunch of different camps. There's the technical wakeboard style, two-line riding, which is real, you know, young, progressive, technical-oriented trick type of riding, all the way to kind of cruiser, you know, people that you wouldn't expect to get into an extreme sport like this. Guys out there on four-line kites, just, you know, using it as a way to get back into the water.
every day is different. Every day is so different. Whenever you go down there, you have to go there with a very open mind. Look at the conditions and see them for how they truly are versus how they appear. And that's a hard thing to do, because if you want to go down there and jump really high, you want it to be windy that day. And if you go down there, you're going to be like looking at the wind going, oh yeah, it's really windy. I know it's windy. And then you go out and next thing you know, bam, the wind is gone. And you're just standing there literally and watching your kite fall out of the sky and looking around you and you're like, oh my God, I have a really, really long ways to swim back.
riding is one of the most frustrating and challenging sports there is. It will rip you apart in a flat second. It'll leave you broken and twisted and not even knowing why or how it happened. So fast, it'll just beat you down. You might have a full killer day of kiteboarding. At the end of the day, you can't even walk because every muscle, your entire back, butt, legs, arms, everything is tweaked. So you have to be in good shape to kite. You can also be lazy and overweight and still kite because you can just take it easy. But if you want to push it, kiting will definitely push you as far and farther than you can ever go.
There's not one way in what to ride. You ride whatever you want, whatever kite, whatever neckline, whatever board, straps, no straps, no bindings. So I think everybody realized that that's the direction the kiteboarding will be, and everybody can always come up with new boards, and they're gonna do different stuff, and it'll be special and unique in, you know, in that specific way. So that's what kiteboarding is.
That's what I like about Kite Beach is guys are out here and they're giving it 120%. And they're throwing their stuff, they're pissed off sometimes, sometimes they're really happy. But that's why everybody is pushing it as hard as they do and does what they do at this beach. It's because they got attitudes to try it as hard as they can all the time. We're not out here just trying to smile, cruise around, and enjoy this like, you know, a weekend on the lake with your windsurf board. It's a totally different aspect of the sport here. This is, you know, laying it on the line. And, you know, people shouldn't take it personal. I mean, you know, that's just how it is. And, you know, someone's going to be swearing and yelling, and the next day they'll save your kite or drag you in or help you out on the beach. People, they just take this place all wrong.
Ringing in my ears, and it felt
It's just doing what you never thought you could do. I would say there's been maybe 50 times in the 5 years that I've lived in Maui that I've drove home smiling so hard, I mean, I almost hurt. Like, I got home and had to, like, think about some bad shit because it's hurting my face, you know? I mean, that's how much fun it is. It's like, it's those 50 times out of 5 years that you hope for, and each day you work toward that. And the funniest part about it is it comes when you don't expect it.
takes dedication. It takes dedication. It takes a death. And only God can allow it. And you couldn't do it if you're not the seed of God. And so the path through the great corridors, these are corridors unto his perfection, that is, which the prophet, the Urim and Thummim, has penetrated, that through this great sea of blackness that I penetrated through these corridors, and I went through that last segment where I went through these dark serpentines. I passed through that corridor where they sat, where they are. And when you penetrate to the Most High God, you will believe you're mad. You will believe you've gone insane. But I tell you, if you follow the secret window and you die to the ego nature, you will penetrate this darkness. Oh yes, there is many a man or woman that's been put in the same asylum, and this has happened to them. And they're sitting there today, people think they're insane. They saw something, the dream. And they see it when they're on drugs. The only thing is they see it not through the light of God. And the way I showed you, I show you to see it through the light of God and the understanding of God. Because when you see the face of God, you will die. And there will be nothing left in you except the God-man, the God-woman, the heavenly man, the heavenly woman, the heavenly child. There'll be prayer on your lips day and night. There'll be a song of jubilee waiting for your king. There will be nothing you will be looking for in this world, excepting for your God. This is all a dream in death. And so I went through that with you. I encountered hell, the great serpentines of the highest order. And I went through that when I showed you chart number 3. The question is asked in Urim and Thummim concerning the pit. This horrible pit of miry clay.
Thank you.